Protein is an important macronutrient, really involved in almost all bodily functions and processes. And of all the macronutrients, protein comes in first for weight loss. In this video, I'm going to share with you three ways in which protein helps you lose weight, how much protein you need to lose weight, as well as an interesting protein source that you may consider over your typical whey protein. So let's get started. If you guys are new here, my channel is all about helping you make informed decisions about your health and wellness, and I would love for you all to gently tap on the like button down below. And if you really like the content, then consider subscribing as well. Also, if you're on Instagram, you can follow me there too. Now, without wasting any more time, let's get started. So we all need protein since it's essential for making enzymes and hormones, and it helps to transport nutrients and oxygen throughout the body. Without it, our bodies would not function properly. This is why the body breaks down its own muscle to use for essential functions if the diet isn't providing enough of protein. And protein is made up of smaller units we call amino acids. And there are 20 amino acids that the body needs to function. And 9 of these are considered essential because the body can't produce them on its own, which means we need them from food sources. Not just so that the body can function, but also a way for the body to lose fat. How exactly? Let's look at the first way. Protein helps you feel full longer. One of the biggest reasons why weight loss is difficult is because of cravings. The hungrier you feel all the time, the harder it is to keep the weight off. This is why medicines like Ozempic target satiety. The longer you feel full, the less likely you are to give in to cravings and overindulge on calories, whether that is snacking before bedtime or just throughout the day. This study on the effects of high protein versus high fat snacks on appetite control, satiety, and eating initiation in healthy women showed us that high protein snacks like yogurt improves appetite control, satiety, and reduces subsequent food intake in healthy women. The second way in which protein helps you lose fat is how it increases the thermic effect on food. And think of the thermic effect as the cost of digesting your food. To put it simple, it takes some energy to break food down, digest it, and turn it into energy, right? Protein has the highest cost of all the three macronutrients. So you essentially burn more calories digesting protein than other macros, giving you a metabolic advantage. This study in postprandial thermogenesis indicated an added energy cost associated with high protein, low fat diets, and may help explain the efficacy of such diets for weight loss. How much exactly is not so clear, but this is a good estimate. 20 to 30% calories used to process protein, 5 to 15 on carbs, and 0 to 5 on fats. So in other words, if we go with a thermic effect of 30% for protein, this means that 100 calories of protein only end up as 70 usable calories, which is awesome. The third way is unique in that it helps prevent weight regain. Let's say you lost a bunch of weight either through medicines like Ozempic or Wegovy, or exercise and diet, and you don't want to regain all that weight back that you worked so hard to lose. This study titled High Protein Intake Sustains Weight Maintenance After Body Weight Loss in Humans, they found that at a modest increase in protein intake from 15 to 18% of calories reduced weight regain after weight loss by 50%, which I know is a real struggle if you've already regained some of that weight back already, but switching to a higher protein can be a solution to start out with. But the next question is, how much protein do I need to lose that body fat? And that depends on what your protein needs are. And there are a ton of different online calculators that you can use as well, but this chart summarizes that. This is to prevent deficiency, this one is for the elderly, this one you can calculate to build muscle, but this one here is for weight loss, 0.7 grams per pound. So if you're 180 pounds, 0.7 grams times 180, you'll need about 126 grams of protein to get the weight loss benefits from the protein. The numbers don't need to be exact, which is why anything in the range of 25 to 35% of calories should be effective. And if you're looking to supplement your protein but have digestive problems with whey or milk-based protein supplements, this double-blind placebo-controlled trial looked at pea protein versus whey and found no difference obtained between the two protein groups. Vegetable pea proteins could be used as an alternative to whey-based dietary products, which studies do show us that pea protein is still associated with increased satiety, reduced calorie intake, and improved muscle mass. and I've left a few of my favorite ones down below, not sponsored, but ones that I'm currently trying to take. I'm more curious to hear from you though. Has eating more protein helped you lose weight? Let me know what your thoughts are down below. In the meantime, click the subscribe button if you found any value in this video. And until then, guys, I'll see you on the next one.